This follows the tabling of three loan requests by the Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, in which the government seeks to borrow $250 million from the International Monetary Fund and another $90 million from the same fund.
Borrow up to €500 million from Amarok Capital Limited, Sovereign Infrastructure Group, and other financial institutions to finance the government of Uganda budget for financial year 2022-2023.
However, the proposal to borrow $500 million from Amarok Capital Limited and Sovereign Infrastructure Group act MPs after they discovered that Amarok Capital Limited is a private money lender in Kenya.
You're dealing with a company which is lending to private companies, and we're going there as Uganda to support our budget, a national budget, to a company whose experience is loaning to private companies to the extent of $10 to $100 million.
Stanbic Bank was not providing money, was not asking for a loan fee. These ones are asking for 1.6 something as arrangement fee. Now, when you also go, Stanbic Bank was going to borrow to use money, one, to mobilize resources domestically, and the rest of the other money from South Africa. Now you go to imperialists who are going to mobilize money from this Morgan and these other fellows.
MPs question the capacity of Amarok Capital Limited to provide funding to the government, yet the same company has been operating in Uganda to provide private equity firms, mainly in agriculture, money to the tune of 5 million shillings and 10 million shillings. This prompted MPs to ask the Ministry of Finance to furnish Parliament with the due diligence report that was carried out on Amarok Limited.
We are suffering with integrity issues here as a country, to slip from tier one banks to a street money lender to support our budget. I think it sounds a little offensive to the integrity of this country, and we need serious confirmation on this matter.
My problem is, I've been telling Minister, this is the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development. Don't they sit amongst the ministerial bodies or to sit as ministries and discuss the way to plan for the country?
Butambala County MP Mwanga Chivumbi asked government to produce the intelligence report by the Financial Intelligence Authority conducted on Amarok Limited before the agreement to seek funding from the company was reached upon.
It will be helpful if we can see more information, also because I saw in the minister's report that the financial intelligence looked into this. I think we'd like to see exactly what they checked, because from their own side, they have never handled the sort of money which we're looking for.
Requesting for the intelligence report, which they depended on, and from the National Intelligence Authority, Financial Intelligence Authority, that looked into these companies and did the due diligence.
Lawmakers also asked the Ministry of Finance to assure Parliament on Amarok's capacity to raise these funds, noting that none of the two give them confidence.
Who has been selling chicken suddenly is going to say it's going to supply cattle? It's not going to happen. Even if you say these ones are backing, it is not proven.
It is taking us to the streets to look for Amarok. But true, we are lagging behind in terms of time. There are activities which are projected, and any delayed project means additional costs.
The Minister Musasizi informed the committee that the decision to resort to Amarok followed an earlier failure by Standard Chartered Bank to provide the €273 million as earlier agreed, and the funding from Amarok will save Uganda 1.9 billion shillings on cost of financing as compared to hitting the domestic market.
Parliament approved commercial budget support loan amounting to €455.03 million from the Standard Chartered Bank and other financial institutions.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.